Once in a while on this show, you come across something which is either the best idea you've ever seen or the worst. And the best idea, look at this, Rajiv. I've seen this everywhere.
I have to say, Vikram, by no stretch of your imagination, are you right or wrong this time? Because you're actually right.
Of course I'm right.
It's the product is amazing. Where it is may not be.
Even that's a bit confusing. Now, why am I saying this is possibly the best idea? It's a stretch limo, which can function as a boardroom inside. You can have your meetings, you can have conversations, Wi-Fi. You don't care how long you're sitting inside.
Or why Vikram likes it, because it can also be a bar room inside.
Yeah, it can be a bar room. Right? So you don't care how much time you're spending inside that vehicle, which is theoretically a good idea if you're in traffic in Delhi or Bangalore or any other place. The bad idea part comes...
If you're in traffic.
I mean, it's the exact same thing. Can you actually get this through enough places?
So I think the idea is very cool. Like I said, we're really going to stretch your imagination with this stretch, the Chrysler limo. I think it's a great idea. They have other forms and functions. Listen, let me tell them about the fact that there's a bar inside, so say bye to Vikram, you won't be seeing him again.
But here's the entire lineup on today's show.
Time to hit the road, because we are taking the Gadget Gurus for a ride. But this one is like none other. And get set to say hey Google as we get the brand new Google Home and Home Mini on the show. And these babies are coming up, so we better get the party started.
So now, here's the deal. If you're just taking this at a party to make an impression on somebody and to get the looks of everybody, I'm not sure what the point is. Now,
you asked the question and answered it. The point ideally is you to take a date out.
Ideally, you should imp- look, Rajiv. I mean, at least in my life, you impressed your dates with personality, with charm, weight, intelligence, humor. You know, all of those things.
But you know,
if
I mean,
you need
I've
a limo to do it, then okay, good luck to you.
In a world where the current generation has instant gratification of everything, even sex is a right swipe. They're confused as to what you're talking about
right
now.
Sex is not the right swipe. Finding someone to have sex with is a right swipe.
Foreplay is a right swipe.
Okay, this is not the time for a
foreplay. Foreplay is a right swipe for sure. Okay.
Okay, now hang on. You know what I think this is more useful for? I think these guys are onto something. But not this.
What, this? This?
Yeah. This is not it. A bar shah, this is shusha. They have another variant of this, which has got a boardroom inside it, right? And a meeting room. Now, I think if whoever the guys are who've done this, they need to be told...
Eco-rent a car.
So they need to be told, guys, what you really should do is put this into something like a Fortuner or a Bajaj Tempo Traveler, right? Have a place where you have a round meeting room. You put that up for rental. So somebody arrives in Delhi and says, Bangalore, my God. Imagine being able to do that in Bangalore, where you say, I'm flying into Bangalore for a day, and I'm going to have my meetings when on the road, because it takes an hour to get from anywhere to anywhere. You can have your meetings in the boardroom, get onto one location, move to another location. As an idea, not bad.
Okay, as an idea, it's great. So that is Vikram's idea of what he'd do in this. I think this is just perfect for me. So I can give you a lot of ideas on what I would do.
It's a family channel, so let's not. That
is almost a bed, what you're on right now,
Rajiv.
Vikram.
It is a family.
For me to rest,
we will leave Rajiv with his fantasies for a moment. And instead, show you what a limo like this is capable of, and also what the other possibilities are. You should be able to use something like
Absolutely.
This.
Absolutely.
With a boardroom. Wi-Fi, work as you're commuting.
Not always do we get to take Vikram and Rajiv for a ride. But when we do, we gotta make sure it's done in style. That's why we got on to eco-rent-a-car to get a luxurious limousine. You can take your pick from the different vehicles that they offer, from an opulent drive to a vintage car or an automobile for corporate meetings. This website caters to it all. The limousine that we drove around was equipped with LED screens that can play DVDs. There is a laptop and mobile charger if you would need it. It also has Wi-Fi for connectivity. You can rent it for approximately 20,000 for about 4 hours. The cost may differ from city to city and according to the time of the day. A limo is of course targeted at those who want to flaunt the vehicle and travel around town with a hint of style and panache. A more noble concept is that of boardroom on wheels.
No matter how much money you have, right, or no matter how expensive a car that you can buy, right? When you're stuck in a traffic jam, whether it's a Mercedes or an auto rickshaw, everybody's stuck in a traffic jam. So what is the best alternative to use that time on the road when you're stuck in the traffic jam? Is to hire a boardroom van like this, where you can have all your key team members. Why not use that 2 hours on the road productively, where you can carry out your meetings and get some work done?
The boardroom concept is essentially targeted at company heads, those who are on the move at all times and would like to hold a meeting on the go. The Toyota Venturi is assigned for it, which has rotating seats along with a monitor that can play DVDs. Two of the seats are massage chairs and you can pamper yourself while driving. The rental starts at about 5,500 rupees for 4 hours for about 40 kilometers. The rent-a-car concept is quite popular and people do tend to indulge in some of these luxuries once in a while. However, the concept of a boardroom on wheels per se does seem a little speculative. We wonder how many would actually hire a car to hold a meeting. After all, wouldn't you want minimal distractions in a meeting? Moreover, we really feel that for a complete boardroom experience, it would have been better suited with some way of connecting a projector or attaching a laptop or pen drive. Also, an easy-to-use mobile app is very critical. As of now, you can only book it through their website, ecorentacar.com, or the helpline numbers.
Right now, Delhi and CR, I mean Delhi, Mumbai, Delhi, Gurgaon and Noida. Then we have it in Mumbai, we have it in Bangalore, we have it in Hyderabad, and we have it in Chennai. And in soon, we are going to be also launching it to other cities like Cochin, Kolkata, Pune, you know, so that we can have more and more people across the country have the benefit of having a van like this.
So next time that you're planning an evening out with friends and have a few thousands to spare, maybe you could indulge in some fancy driving across town.
But talking about working when you're traveling, here's something you might not look at. Apple's come out with the iPad with a stylus.
So a normal iPad now with a stylus, predominantly for some reason towards the student community, because I think they seem to be thinking the price is now right. But you know, everything we're going to do on the show, I'm going to keep asking you one question. Of course, we'll review this. Of course, we'll talk about who is it right for. But every time we review something, do you think adding that onto that car that you're thinking and fantasizing about would be great? So maybe it should come with built-in iPads, Wi-Fi, and then
I'm about to add something else to it. So we'll show you the iPad and we'll add the next thing. So visualize this. You've got a vehicle like this with a table inside it, Wi-Fi, obviously, television, well, yeah, it's theoretically possible.
Well, iPad
enough,
with 4G,
right? You can do it. Then you have these iPads, so you can work on them.
And watch TV,
And watch TV on them. So all of that, good to go. We'll tell you about the iPad. I mean, add one more item to it.
It was meant to be the iPad for all, but is it really? This is the new Apple iPad 9.7 inch and this one is targeted specially for students. For starters, it has an A10 Fusion chipset that can be useful for graphic-heavy games, 4K video editing, and even some augmented reality apps. In fact, this one is made for AR usage. The camera at the back is 8 megapixel, which is decent for a tablet. It also supports first generation Touch ID. It has a Retina screen for vivid and rich colors. It gives about 10 hours of battery life on a single charge, which lasts through the day. But now the headline making feature of the device. That's the Apple Pencil support. You can get as creative as you want and use Procreate, Adobe Photoshop, Sketch, take notes, or simply doodle. Needless to say, Apple has looked into all the finer details and ensured that there's almost no lag with the pencil. The 32GB Wi-Fi model is priced at 28,000 rupees and the Wi-Fi and cellular model is at 38,600 rupees. The Apple Pencil will have to be purchased separately for about 7,600 rupees.
Okay, now what are you adding, Vikram? We've taken a look at the iPad. What are you adding to this?
Look at this. Something like this, right? This is the Google Home. Now this is Wi-Fi enabled. So you've got this. You can be listening to music. You can get it to do all sorts of things. You can use it. You can use, obviously, use, you know, an Amazon.
I would actually connect this via Bluetooth to the car system and then utilize this as my go-to for music, go-to for all information. I'm in the middle of a board meeting. I can even ask, what's that information about? And you get it and everybody else can hear it. I think this could be a great add-on. I mean, now you've got a limo, you've got a boardroom, and you've got a smart boardroom.
Sorry, I'm getting distracted because I actually do want to listen to this. So if you don't mind.
You want me to connect it to the Bluetooth right now?
No, let's just actually put this through the paces. Our team was putting this through its paces. I want to just check out their review.
If you're looking for a roommate who's always ready with a helping hand or even entertain you when you're bored, we may have found the perfect partner for you. Say hello to Google Home, or rather, OK Google.
OK Google.
The first variants, Google Home and Home Mini, have been launched in India at a price tag of 9,999 and 4,499 rupees, respectively. The global launch happened a while back, but India had to wait way too long for this. What was the delay?
We wanted to make sure we can deliver the product in a high quality way. And that meant understanding what are the types of questions, what are the type of things that Indian consumers really want. And so we've been learning, we've been testing them internally with even local Googlers about what are the type of experiences people want. We want to make sure we had local content on the product. So, you know, we've been partnering with Savan and Ghana. And so we want to make sure that we deliver a great product for India. It's not just about taking the US product and bringing it here, it's about really localizing it. And so that's what the investment we've been making.
The Google Home elevates the current trend of talking to your device and takes it on another level. Setting it up is no biggie. Just download the Google Home app on your Android or iOS device and follow the steps to set it up. The device and the phone have to be connected on the same Wi-Fi connection. It has a minimalist design, fabric mesh at the bottom and plastic at the top. The top interface is entirely touch sensitive. It has to be connected using its proprietary adapter. It is equipped with two far-field microphones to hear you out loud and clear. Up to 6 accounts can be synced to the home, and it is able to recognize different accents. Once synced, you can ask your Google Assistant for literally anything at all, be it a recipe for your favorite dish.
Okay, Google, show me recipe for aloo tikki.
Or scheduling a reminder or digging out some trivia about any current affair. This little speaker will give out any information. The Indian avatar of this device understands the Indian accent better and responds accordingly.
Do you know my name?
Your name is Anushash.
Most of the time, the assistant understood our commands, though there were instances where we had to rephrase the command for Google to respond.
Okay, Google, what's my name?
Sorry, I didn't catch that. Could you try saying that one more time?
Okay, Google, what is my name?
As I couldn't verify your voice just now, I can't tell you that.
If you have other Google devices, for instance, Chromecast, it can play content on TV screen directly. If not, you can always use the home speaker. If you have smart light or any other connected devices, you can control them using the assistant. In India, they have tied up with Savan and Ghana for music streaming. However, you cannot use it to book a cab on Uber or order food using Zomato. So in that sense, it has to turn out more desi. For those who have privacy concerns, there is a toggle button for the mic. However, it makes little sense to use Google Home if you keep the microphone muted. Then there is also this petite version called the Home Mini. The size of a donut, the Mini's setup and functionality remain similar to the bigger one, but the speaker quality is quite disappointing. You can connect it using Bluetooth, but it cannot be connected to a larger speaker. It would be great to have an embedded battery so that maneuvering it around at home would have been much easier, perhaps for the next version. Besides these, there is Google Home Max as well that has hit some international markets. Can we expect it in India?
We have the right product and experience around Google Home Max. So Google Home Max is our high-end speaker. Mm-hmm. It's a fairly large speaker, and it can actually fill a very large room. But what we want to do is first start with what we think are the most accessible products for us. Google Home Mini and Google Home are our most accessible products we've had globally, and so we're starting there. Max actually hasn't even launched outside the US yet. We're still looking at all the different mm-hmm. markets, so it just takes a little bit of time. But look, we want to continue to bring all our devices to the Indian market.
With Amazon expanding on with the Echo ecosystem, it will be interesting to see how the two compete against one another, and more importantly, whether they will be able to get more people bring home a virtual assistant.
But you know what? In the middle of all this high-tech stuff that we're doing, let's move to normal tech, which is a little bit of pet puja. We'll take a break. We'll be right back. So before we go to the next two products, Vikram, I have to tell you, Nishant Padhyar, our friend, did something very interesting. He took a Ford Mustang And instead of using the music system that comes with the car, he packed it with really nice, big, large, portable Bluetooth speakers, but the big ones, not those small little ones. And he said that he thought the experience was amazing. The only thing you have to think about is, do you want luggage in your boot or do you want a big, fat speaker? What do you think?
Big fat speaker, obviously, what else?
I mean,
yeah, but let's check out a bunch of these really interesting new portable speakers and see if we can put one of them into this as well.
Energy System, a Spanish brand, has finally made its entry into India. And if you want to get the party started, Energy System has just the mood set up. The Party 6 speaker is a complete package with surround sound and light show. It is fitted with a microphone, a control panel with equalizer, and an LED display. It is a 2.1 speaker with 240-watt power. It also houses microphone and guitar input to connect your music equipment to it. There is RCA in and out to connect several Energy Party 6 speakers and customize your music. You can also play your music wirelessly from distance up to 10 meters with the latest Bluetooth 4.0 and its users. Alternately, you can control all the functions using a remote control. It is priced at around 25,000 rupees. Then there is the Tower G2. This one too is a 2.1 speaker with digital sound processor to make the most of the music. It features an optical input that ensures playback of sound to the highest quality, the latest Bluetooth technology and FM. There is a USB and micro SD reader and charging port for the device. This too has RCA in and out to connect different units. The price of this one starts at 19,000 rupees. But if you think that these speakers are too big in size and difficult to carry around, there is a compact alternative as well. And not just compact, this one comes with a pair of wheels. Yes, it's a speaker on trolley, and we do wish that other bulky speakers also consider this design format. This is the Zook Beatbox Pro with trolley. The speaker is equipped with a high-quality amplifier and has Bluetooth connectivity and built-in FM. There is also USB port, aux and input for guitar. There is digital display as well. But what sets it apart is this, a DJ console with which you can trigger different sounds and create your own mashups. And when it comes to the speaker quality, it is really loud. However, consider this only if you have enough space to place it around. The Zook Beatbox Pro is priced at around 18,000 rupees.
You know, of course, one of the interesting things is what you can do on devices like this. Banks now coming up with their own apps and
based on. So HDFC Ergo now, Alexa and voice enabled, so you can actually ask a lot of things, including how much money is in your wife's account.
I'm not quite sure you want to necessarily be doing this on speakers and how much data you want to put online. But
no,
okay.
I'd love to come into your house and say, Alexa, transfer so much into Rajiv Makhni's account. That would really be cool.
I have already set my Alexa to not listen to your voice, no matter what happens.
But I think it's a very cool idea. I think the level of information that you really want out, HDFC's taken care of that. Let's take a look at how it works.
No doubt, the trend of talking to your devices is here to stay. We started the show with some smart speakers, and now it is time to take a look at how companies are using this service for better customer service.
I can help you with your HDFC Ergo related queries like products offered.
HDFC Ergo, a popular insurance company, has developed its chatbot supported by Amazon Alexa. Users with existing Amazon Echo can enable this feature through the Alexa app. Once you download the app on your phone, you can sync it to your account. The app is simple to use with an easy interface. All you got to do is ask Alexa for all those queries. For instance,
what products are offered by HDFC Ergo?
HDFC Ergo offers many different products in four-wheeler, two-wheeler, health, personal accident, travel, and home insurance.
Or maybe,
which is the closest garage?
And Alexa will suggest a response accordingly. You can locate nearby branches, hospitals, request policy copies, or understand other products offered by HDFC Ergo. It is interesting to see insurance companies trying to use technology in innovative ways. Other companies too are stepping into this. So how is the HDFC Ergo app any different?
We have built host of services at our online channel, mobile, bots, and now on Alexa also, where customer can get most of the services online in real time. You want a policy copy, you can get it in minutes. You want to find out any, you know, how to register a claim, how to make any changes in your policy altogether, that all can be serviced in a real time, in a self-service mode. You do not have to really call our call center or write to us at all to get any kind of service.
Even though there are several advantages of a chatbot or Alexa support, many users still prefer traditional customer service. How does HDFC Ergo plan to change the mindset?
Somebody speaks to bot, you can expect a straight answer. There is no attempt to oversell, no attempt to prejudge what the customer is asking and try to give the answer. They simplistically understand what the human is asking and try to give a very straight answer, totally unbiased. They do not have revenue targets, they do not have to earn their commissions, etc.
Now, we're not sure if the app can completely replace and do away with customer service, but no doubt it will be an easier and faster solution to most user FAQs. After all, everything will be just a voice command away.
All right, now if I can just ask you to stop the car on the left-hand side, please.
And we'll just...
Because, Rajiv, I think there's a puncture. You've got to get off in your seat. Seriously, can't you feel the bumping?
No.
I'm telling you, it's bumping. Let's get off and see it.
Oh, yeah, what puncture, man? No puncture. Oi, 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 oi. Typical of Vikram. So that was a prank. In Delhi summer, he's gone off in a limo. Auto bhai sahab, ruk jao yaar zara. I'm going in an auto.